How you doing, Mr. Tiberi here? This is another video from Elgin High School Auto Shop. We're going to take a look at how to utilize a brake drum micrometer. So right here we have a AMMCO drum brake micrometer, and it's got a dial gauge on it, and then it's got a graduated gauge right here. It kind of looks like a ruler. You got a ruler on both sides actually. We're going to take a closer look at that later. So you're going to need a drum brake micrometer, you're going to need a tape measure, you're also going to need your drum. And I recommend a sheet of paper and a pen, because you're going to have to take some measurements and write some things down to accurately determine if your drum is out of round. We're making this measurement so we can determine how much material we can cut out of the inside of this drum. As you can see right now, you can determine the thickness of the lining where the friction material from our brake shoes is going to make contact with the inside of the drum. We want to know how much of this material we can cut away, or if it's worn down to the point where we have to discard this drum. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is we're going to find out just how big this diameter can be. So you can look this up under manufactured specifications, so if you know the year, make, and model of your vehicle. But another tip is if you take a look on the drum itself, there's typically markings that show you in millimeters what your measurement is. So we've got it right here up on the top. It might be a little difficult to see, so I'm going to move this stuff to the side. So right here it says 230.0 millimeters. Now if you really can't read it, you could try a trick where you take a piece of chalk and just rub it over the top. And then wipe it down. Then it pops up and you can see it a little bit clearer. So it'll come out, it's 230.0 mm. So you take a towel, wet cloth, wipe it across, and it'll pop up at you. Now this is a good measurement, but the downside to this one is it's in millimeters, and our drum brake micrometer measures within inches. So we're going to have to convert 230 millimeters into inches, which is not too terribly complicated to do, but you, for the most part, you're going to need a calculator. All right, so right here we have 1 millimeter equals 0.0390. Our drum measures to a maximum diameter of 230.0 millimeters. So all we got to do is take 230 and multiply it by 0.0393. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to knock that one out real quick. So we're going to take a look. I'm going to clear that out. So we're going to take 230. And you can put the 0.0, it's not totally necessary. Multiply that out by 0.0393. There is our maximum drum diameter in inches. So we have 9 inches and 39 thousandths. So we'll just put that on the paper. All right, so now that I know when I make my measurement with the drum brake micrometer, I can't exceed 9 inches and 39 thousandths. If my measurement, my diameter inside of my drum is larger than that, I'm going to have to discard it. All right, now the math's done for that part. We're going to go ahead and we're going to measure the drum. All right, now for the next step, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look. We're going to use a tape measure. We're going to measure the inside diameter. This is going to give us a rough measurement. You're going to measure to an eighth of an inch. Okay? So we set up the end of the tape measure right on the outside wall, and we take a look at it just like this. And we set up our tape measure, and we are at right about 8 inches and 7/8. Okay? That's that mark right there. So we got 8 7/8 inches. So that's my pre-measurement. I'm going to use that so I can set up my drum brake micrometer. All right, so I'm gonna hold this drum brake micrometer. We're gonna zoom in a little bit in a minute here, but we're gonna take a look. So this is the dial side of my drum brake micrometer. And what you're gonna notice, this is a plunger right here. And as I push on that plunger with my finger, notice the dial gauge moving? Okay, that's gonna come in handy a little bit later on. But that measures within thousandths of an inch. So and we're gonna add that to our final measurement once we get to the, kind of at the end. So we're gonna take a look at the scale. So we have a ruler that's essentially set up. It starts right here in the center. What you'll notice is there's a 6 right here, and then there's a 7 and a 6 right here. It's going to go up in measurements. The smallest diameter that this micrometer can measure is 6 inches. It can't measure any drum smaller than 6 inches, which is perfectly fine, because you'll be hard-pressed to find a drum that small. However, its maximum diameter that it can go out to is 16 inches. Okay, so the drum diameter of like 16 inches is going to be enormous. So for our purpose, what we measured was 8 7/8 of an inch. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set this up. Over here is a stationary side. This side we're going to set up to the 8-inch mark. Okay, so you're going to locate the 8 on the left side. And then there's an arrow located right here. This arrow is going to point on that 8. Once you have that, you're going to lock it down on top. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and I'm going to zoom in, and we're going to take a close look at that. So right here, you notice that we have an 11 and a 10. So we're going to keep moving this until we can get to that. And I have a 9 and an 8 right there, which is fine because the 8 is there. So I'm going to go ahead, set it up so that the arrow right up top here is pointing at that 8. Now if the drum was 9 inches and big, you would set it to the same place. Now that I have that, I'm going to lock down the top. Pretty firm. You want to make sure that there's no wiggle or anything like that. Okay, so that's the left side of the drum brake micrometer. Next we're going to go over to the right side. Since my drum with the tape measure measured 8 7/8 of an inch, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a look at this side. And you'll notice that I've got the 8 mark located right here. There's a 7 on top, but I'm going to disregard that because on this side I'm pointing at the 8. So if I was to take the dial side over here, loosen it up, and bring it all the way over right where the 8 is, what that essentially means is that if I locked it down right there and then we looked at the dial and I pushed this plunger in and that needle reads at 0 exactly, that means it's exactly 8 inches from the tip right here to this tip right here. Of my whole brake drum micrometer. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the dial side and I'm going to move this side out until it's at the 8 7/8 inch mark. So we'll go back in and I'll make that adjustment. So there's the 8 right down there. There's my arrow up top. So that right there, that first mark that we pass is 8 1/8. We got 8 1/4, 8 3/8, 8 1/2, okay, 8 5/8, 8 3/4, and that's my 8 7/8. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna lock it down on the 8 7/8 mark. Just gonna line it up as best you can so you can just barely see that mark. Alright. Now my drum brake micrometer is set up to 8 7/8 of an inch. So the next step is we're going to insert the drum brake micrometer inside the drum. Alright, so now I've got my drum set up right down in front of me. I'm going to take my drum brake micrometer right here. You're going to take the plunger side right here. You're going to slip this side inside the drum first. So the dial side goes in the drum first. Put it in on an angle just like that. So when you push on it, it compresses that plunger, which gives you room to put in this side right here. So we're going to go ahead set it right down in place. Okay. Now, what you're going to notice is the needle is now deflected on this gauge. Okay. So my drum brake micrometer is measured to 8 7/8 inch, and then I've got this needle right here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take 8 7/8 and I'm going to convert that into decimal form. So you have to convert 7/8 inch into decimal form, and then we can add whatever we read on this dial to that decimal. So if I have 8 7/8 inch, what I want to do is convert 7/8 inch. So you can do this kind of math inside of your head. 3/4 inch is 750 thousandths, 0.750. I just have to add an eighth to that. So you have to add an additional 0.125, so 125 thousandths, which is going to give you 895 thousandths. So we have 8 inches and 895 thousandths. So now that I know that, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take this micrometer and I'm going to manipulate it around. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stare at this gauge. While I move the micrometer forward and back, I'm pulling this side tight up against the side of the drum. So I'm just going to wrap my thumb around this area right here. I'm going to squeeze it up against the wall of the drum, the inner wall of the drum. And then I'm going to rotate. I'm going to push this around. Notice this needle deflects. What I want to do is I want to watch the stall point of the needle. And that's where the needle stops and changes position. So when it starts deflecting and then it reverses itself. So the stall point, as you can see here, is right there. It's at 120. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that 120 and I'm going to add it to the 895 thousandths that I have. Okay, so right here you can see I got 8 inches and 895 thousandths of an inch, and I just simply added the 120 that we found on that dial. And that gave me a total of 9 inches and 15 thousandths. Now remember, my maximum diameter cannot go above 9 inches and 39 thousandths. Okay? So far, it looks like I have plenty of room. Okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the drum back. And seeing as I got that measurement, you're going to take and you're going to rotate this micrometer, you're going to spin it 90 degrees. Put it back into position, and you're going to remeasure. This is going to allow us to determine if the drum is out of round. So I'm going to go ahead, again, I'm going to hold this point right here, and then I'm going to rotate, and I'm going to watch for the stall point of my needle. Stall point again is right around 120 thousandths, so I'm going to keep it right there. So what that means is that it's the exact same measurement, 90 degrees. So this drum is a perfect circle. Okay? It's not oval, which is a good thing, because if it was, we would generate brake pedal pulsation, and we want to avoid that. So now we'll go back to the paper and we'll do a little bit more math. Okay, so my measurement that I came up with, so this is my drum. So the first measurement would be A, and that measurement I got 9 inches and 15 thousandths. My second measurement when I rotated 90 degrees was B, same thing. Now, what I want to do is I want to find out what the outer round of the drum is. So if it's not perfect, I want to find out what that is. The easy way to do it is you take A and B and you subtract them. And if I subtract 9 inches and 15 thousandths, obviously from the same, we get 0. Okay? 0.0. So my out of round is 0. So that is perfect. That means my drum is nice and it's a perfect circle. Okay? So the next thing we want to do is we want to determine our cuttable thickness. How much material can we remove from the drum before we reach our maximum discard thickness? For that, we have to take 9 inches and 15 thousandths, and we have to subtract that from 9 inches and 39 thousandths. And that'll give us our discard thickness. All right, so here we go with some more simple math. We have our maximum line D, which is 9 inches and 39 thousandths of an inch. Let's be precise here. Our actual value, what we measured, was 9 inches and 15 thousandths of an inch. We're going to subtract the two, okay? Subtract the actual from your maximum. This is going to tell us our cuttable thickness, how much material that we have available that we can remove from the drum itself. So, I'll fire this off. 9 and 9, 0, 0, 0, 3 minus 1, we got 2, 9 minus 5, 4, so we have 24 thousandths of material that we can remove safely from the drum before we reach our maximum ID. Now, granted, if this was a customer's vehicle and I had to put this back on, I probably wouldn't cut this. I would stay away from anything around 20 thousandths. If it's 20 thousandths and you have to cut it due to the fact that you possibly have a lack of parallelism or if it's out of round, then you want to make sure you replace the drum, because 24 thousandths won't be enough material to remove in order to bring it back to shape. Okay, you're looking right around the neighborhood of anywhere from like 60 to 40. So even 30 you could possibly cut, but when you get down to 20s, I wouldn't cut it. So at that point, you would just discard it and get a new drum. Okay, so that's how to use a brake drum micrometer.